Hello YouTube, today I will show you how to jailbreak iOS 5 devices and create a YouTube API key to fix the old built-in YouTube app on iOS 5 and below. Supported devices will be listed in the description. To start off, we need to jailbreak the device. I will be using an iPod Touch 3rd generation, but this can be done on any device that is on iOS 5. I will also show my jailbroken iPad 1st generation later on when we look at how to fix YouTube. Now, on this one, I'm using iOS version 5.1.1, the newest it can handle. In order to jailbreak iOS 5, this is one of the simplest jailbreaks that can be done, and it's great for those who want to try jailbreaking iDevices without the risk of using daily drivers. I will have the websites listed in the description for the download links. For the jailbreak tool, we need something called Absinthe. This will be the first link in the description. This tool is available on macOS, Windows, and Linux. The setup and jailbreak process is exactly the same, with some minor changes depending on the OS. But in this video, I will be using macOS. First off, you need to click on the first link below to download Absinthe. In my case, it's macOS. Now this is what the website will look like. There are several that have the actual download link, but this is the one that's in the description. Now there's one for Mac, Windows, and Linux. Once the file is downloaded, you need to click on it to actually extract it. Now I've already done so, and I have the program right here. I just want to mention, if you're using older versions of macOS, you don't need to do this step. But if it doesn't open, there is an extra step. Now on macOS, if it doesn't run, you first need to actually right-click on the program, show package contents, click on contents, then macOS, and here we can see the file that we need, Absinthe 10.6. Next, we need to open the terminal window. Now, it's simply as dragging the 10.6 file into the terminal, and it will automatically open the Absinthe launcher. After hitting enter, here we can have Absinthe open. Once you reach this point, all you have to click is the jailbreak button. So here, our iPod Touch 3, it's not jailbroken, it's fairly stock, and here it's detected on iOS 5.1.1 in the Absinthe program. Now it's as simple as clicking jailbreak. This is a relatively quick process, and it only takes around 1 to 2 minutes. Once it's done, the Cydia app will appear on the home screen. And there we have it. It's already jailbroken. So if we look at our iPod here, here is Cydia. First time opening it, it will exit us out. This is normal because it's preparing the file system. Once Cydia is initialized, we can open the app again. Now it's going to ask us which sort of profile we want. You can choose whichever one you want, since you can always change it later. And there we have it, a fully untethered jailbreak for iOS 5 devices, and it'll help breathe new life into them. A side note, if there are errors that Cydia reports after it's done initializing, This is normal considering the age of the OS, such as this. This has happened on my iPad first generation as well, but it hasn't affected anything simply because this is an older version, but it's still supported. Now it's time to create the YouTube API key. The link to the website is in the description. Now, going to the website for the first time is going to ask us if you agree to the terms of service and to confirm your location. After you agree, you need to first create a new project right next to the Google Cloud Platform logo. Once you click on it, you will probably not have any projects created, so we first have to create one. Now we have to give it a name. You can name it whatever you want, but since it's going to be for an API key, I'm just going to name mine YouTube API key. After clicking on Create, we can see that the program has been made. Now the next step is to access the side menu and click on API and Services. Then head over to Dashboard. Within this menu, we can see that the program is selected and head over to the side menu again. But this time, click on API Library. Once we are in the API Library, we have to scroll down to find what we actually need. Now here, we have the YouTube section, and we need the YouTube Data API version 3. After clicking on this, we need to select Enable. This will basically give us access to the YouTube servers, and with this key, we can put it into our jailbroken device and make YouTube function again. Now for this, it will take a second for it to enable, but once it's done, we need to click on Create Credentials, which will essentially configure it. So here, once we actually add credentials to our project, we need to make sure that the YouTube Data API version 3 is selected. And then it will ask us where we are calling it from. Using the default web browser one should be adequate. Before clicking on what credentials do I need, you want to make sure which sort of data set you want to access. Public data is the one that we want, since that'll give us access to all the videos that we want. Now here's the API key. I will have it blurred out, since this is user specific. And be sure to not share this with people, because they can also make their own. Now this key is yours. I do not recommend sharing it for security and or privacy reasons. But there we have it, the YouTube API key. Once these steps are completed, it's quite simple to set up the API key. First thing we need to do is to add a specific repo listed on the screen and in the description. Before we do anything, we have to make sure that Cydia is fully updated. Once you get to this screen, make sure you either click Upgrade Essentials or Complete Upgrade. I will be doing Complete Upgrade. This will make Cydia fully updated to what this can run, and it's just going to help with compatibility in the future. After Cydia is fully done updating, we can now install the repo that we need. It will be listed on the screen and in the description. You want to head over to Sources and click on Edit. There will be an Add button, and here we can add the repo that we need. After the repo is put into the box, click on Add Source. Once we can return to Cydia, we head over to the repo, click on Tweaks, scroll down to TubeFixer for iOS, select that, hit on Modify, and click on Install. Click Confirm, and this will download TubeFixer, which will allow us to fix the built-in version of YouTube. We are almost there. So to finish this up, after the device resprings, we have to go over to settings. Now here, there will be a new category called extensions. We scroll all the way down until we see TubeFixer. Now select that and turn on the custom API key. And here, this is what we need the API key for. This will allow us to connect to the YouTube servers and make the built-in YouTube app functional again. And that should be it. Once it's added, the built-in YouTube app should work like it did all those years ago. And as mentioned, here's the jailbroken iPad one. I already had Cydia on here, and I already put TubeFixer, and I just put in the API key. And now, if we look at YouTube, it works just as it should. It loads videos just fine, and it has no problem now. So now, the built-in YouTube app is fully operational.
That's it for this video. Thank you so much for watching.